TK the Science Guy.
TK the Science Guy.
TK the Science Guy.
APES rule.
TK the Science Guy.
Wind power. I'm a big fan.
TK the Science Guy.
TK the Science Guy.
Hey CW Apes, Mr. Kennedy here, and today we're gonna do the Work Power Energy Lab, which can be found on our class webpage under the Energy section. Look for Work Power Energy Lab. There you go. Now this is a really simple activity, but it does require you to get up and get moving. So before I explain how the activity works, I want you to have time to go to our website, get yourself a copy of the handout from the energy section, and meet me back here with your sneakers and sweats on, right? Because we're gonna work out. Hey, glad to have you back. You look like you're ready to go. Don't forget to stretch your hammies because we don't want any pulled muscles now. When you get everything out and ready for this experiment, probably again the most important thing for you to put in your lab report is a set of data tables. Now I'm gonna encourage you to get some folks within your home to get involved and participate in this activity too. It's actually designed for you to work in groups of three. I'm gonna be doing it by myself just to demonstrate what the activity looks like. You grab your family, okay, your close circle, and you know, go exercise a little bit. It doesn't take long, and it's pretty fun. One of the first things that you're gonna have to do as you set this up is you're gonna have to take note of some conversion factors that are right here in this lab handout. You have to be able to do a little bit of math to know like how many, you know, kilograms are in a pound and how to calculate force and acceleration and all that kind of good stuff like that. It's not really hard. It's simple, basic math. And then you're gonna have to ask some potentially like sensitive questions of people like, how tall are you? How much do you weigh? So that you can use that in your calculations. Aside from that, it's all about, well, walking and running. So we're gonna go outside and I'm gonna demonstrate this activity for you. You need to find yourself an incline of some sort, maybe like a hill or some stairs. You can do this inside your house without going anywhere if you have stairs in your house. And what I want you to do once you find that location is just to measure the distance from top to bottom of those stairs or that hill that you're gonna walk or run up. You're gonna need that for your data section. Put the weight of your person, the height of your person, all that kind of stuff like that to work. Fill out your data tables, and then let's go walk. Let's go run. Let's go get our sweat on. All right, see you outside. All right, CW, I'm here at our amazing softball complex. I had to find some place with stairs. So basically, all you gotta do is time me as I walk up these stairs three times, and then I'm gonna run up and down these stairs three times. Now I calculated the distance that I'm gonna travel here. It's 18 feet for you non-metric people, because it does ask for meters. That's 6 meters, okay? 6 meters, all right. So if everybody's ready, I'm gonna stretch out a little bit and get ready to go, and you just time me. Like, I gotta walk up and back. That's one. Gotta do that three times. Here we go. All right, gotta stretch out. I don't know why I'm stretching my arms, because it has nothing to do with walking. But I'm gonna stretch them anyway, because I look cool when I do it, all right? I gotta get the hammy. I gotta get a hammy. Okay, that wasn't my hammy. Those were my quads for you anatomy phys people. All right, here we go. You got the stopwatch ready? On your marks, get set. Go. This is walking. Yeah. Walking.
Savior of the universe.
And I'm coming back.
Whew.
This is
highlighter?
He's saving every one of us.
Yeah.
That's one. Round two. Get that stopwatch ready. Here we go. Woo! Look at that speed. Look at the agility. I don't know if I can even be seen on film. I'm going so fast. Speed of light, baby. That's two. Last rep. Here we go. Oh, wait. You gotta push the stopwatch. Now let's go.
Woo!
Yeah.
Savior of the universe.
There we go. Coming back. He's coming back. Alright, that's three trials, ladies and gents. Make sure you get that down on your data table. And hey, if you're doing this at home with your friends, just do what I just did and write it down. You got it? Okay. Well, guess what time it is? Time for me to run. Oh, guard your eyes. You gotta see Mr. Kennedy run. Alright, so it's up and back, three trials. Get the stopwatch ready. On your marks, get set, and go. Round two. Get that stopwatch ready. Your marks, get set, go.
I skipped a step.
Ooh. That's two. Round three. Get that stopwatch ready. On your marks, get set, go.
I skipped a step. I skipped lots of steps.
That's the third round, and I need a nap. Woo! All right, I've had my nappy night and rest time, so I'm feeling much better after all that running. So what you gotta do is take all this information that we've gathered about your distance, your mass, the force, the work you've done, how long it took you, and you're gonna calculate how many watts of power you used to move your body, or in my case, my body, up and down those stairs three times. And you can compare that. You can compare yourself to me. You can compare yourself to, you know, friends and family in your close circle, doing this inside, or, you know, if you feel comfortable, go outside and find a hill. But tabulate all this. And of course, it wouldn't be a lab if there weren't analysis questions. So after you do your tabulation, after you get all your data together and organized, answer those analysis questions, and I hope you learned a little bit about work, power, and energy. Thanks for joining me out here on the softball field. I'm Mr. Kennedy, and I will see you next time.
TK the Science Guy.
TK the Science Guy.
TK the Science Guy. TK the Science Guy.
Wind power. I'm a big fan.
TK the Science Guy.
TK the Science Guy.